Hey, this is Puneet back again, and without wasting a single second, I just want to tell you that in this video we are going to do a very interesting thing, that's using VLOOKUP function in a VBA code. So let's get started. All right, so here I have a list of names. So this list is basically including 100 names. So 100 names. This might be a small list in your perspective, but let's don't get into this. Just try to write a code to look up for a value. So here I have a column with names, and the second column that I have including scores. So in one column I have names, and the other column I have scores. So now what I want to get score of a particular person from this table to this cell, and for this I'll use VLOOKUP function but through a VBA code. So that is the interesting thing. So the first thing, if you have never used VBA or if you know a little bit about VBA, so we'll do quite a few basic things and then we'll write a code. So the first thing is to activate the developer tab. So for this I'll go to the options and customize ribbon, and from here I will click on developer and then okay. So here I have this developer tab here, right? And now I'll click on Visual Basic to open the Visual Basic editor. And let me open the project window. So I already have a module here, but in your case you might not have that module, so you need to insert a new module. So I'll delete mine and tell you how to insert a new module. So you need to click on the the project where you have this file name, and then go to the insert and click on module. So it gives you a module where you can write your code, and the first thing is to use the sub keyword. So sub keyword is basically tells VBA that we are writing a sub procedure. You don't need to get into the details right now, but let's name this macro. So the first thing is to use the sub keyword and then the name of the macro. So I'll go with a very basic name, VBA underscore VLOOKUP. You can specify name according to your need. And after that I need to enter two parentheses. The one is the opening parenthesis and the closing, and then I'll hit enter. Yes, so the moment I hit enter, it gives me one more a line of code that says end sub. So basically this is the ending of the code. So this is the starting and this is the ending. So now I have to write my code between these two lines, the starting and the ending. All right, so this is one thing that you need to understand here, that if you want to use any of the Excel function in VBA, you need to use a property that property is the worksheet function. So worksheet function property gives you access to all the functions that you have in Excel, the functions that you have in Excel in worksheet. So the moment I press or I enter a dot, it gives me a list of the Excel functions that I can use in this code. So from here I'll move to VLOOKUP, and here I have the VLOOKUP. Now there is one small problem that you might be facing here. So when you normally insert or use a function in your worksheet, it shows you all the arguments that you need to define. So it shows you the arguments with the name of the arguments actually. So here I know the lookup value, table array, column index number and range lookup. But if you go to VBA and try to use the same function in a code, it will not show you the names of the argument. It will show that you need to specify four arguments, the three are required and one is optional, but it will not show you the exact names of the arguments. So the first is lookup value. So lookup value is the value that I want to search for. So I'll specify the cell where I have the lookup value, and that's range E3, and Now the range from where I want to look up for the value is column A and column B. So I'll go with A to B. Now the third argument wants me to specify the column number from where I want to, you know, get the value once I search for a particular name. So I only have two columns. The first is name column and the second is score column. So I want to have score by looking up for the name. So the column is 2, so I'll specify 2. So the fourth argument wants me to specify if I want to do a partial lookup or I want to perform exact lookup. So I want to go for an exact lookup, so I'll use false here. And now as I'm getting an error, so this is basically I need to specify the cell where I want to get the result of this function. So this is also important. You can also you know, specify this cell before actually writing the code for the VLOOKUP. So the cell where I want this result is F3. So I'll specify F3 equals to worksheet function VLOOKUP. And here I have my VLOOKUP function with all the arguments. So the name that I have right now in E3 is Joe. And I want to search for score of Joe. So if I run this code, it should give me the score of Joe. So score is 92 that I got. And let's search if this value is correct or not. All right, so we have Joe and Joe has 92 score, and the score that we got in our cell is 92. So this code is working. This code is actually looking up for a value using the VLOOKUP function in the code. So let me re-explain this thing to you. So first of all, you need to use the worksheet function that gives you access to the to all the functions in Excel. And then you need to specify the function that you want to use. And after that, you need to specify all the arguments that, you know, you should be specifying in the function. And to get the result of the function, you also need to specify a cell, or you can also use a message box if you want. Now let's try to create a button. So if I want to run this code and if I want to, you know, look up for the score for a name, I don't want to go to Visual Basic Editor again and again. I just want to have a button to execute this code. So from here, I'll go to insert illustrations and shapes, and I'll try to insert a small rectangle that just looks like a button. And now I'll right click on this button and go to assign macro and then click on the VBA VLOOKUP, which is the code that I have just written, and click OK. So now that macro, that code is assigned to this shape, and now this shape will act as a button. So if I change the name, for example, if I go with Thomas, so Thomas has 26 score, and if I run this code, it gives me 26. So the code is working and I have a button to run this code. All right, so that's it for this time. I hope you have found this video useful, and please don't forget to subscribe, share and like this video, and I'll be coming out with a lot of cool VBA tips and tricks in coming weeks.